Hi, my name is Milind Pathak, and I am a solutions architect on the SAP team here at AWS. Customers depend on their SAP applications to support their mission-critical lines of business. For this reason, customers tell us that they want ways to migrate SAP applications to AWS with minimal downtime. Today, I'm going to walk you through how to do just that using Cloud Endure migration for a single SAP HANA database server. It enables you to quickly rehost a large number of virtual machines on Amazon EC2 instances. The first step is to register for a Cloud Endure migration account, which is free for AWS customers. Once registered and logged in, you need to confirm your business email ID to activate your account. After this step, you're ready to create a new project. Begin by giving it a project name, selecting a project type, and then create your migration project. Once your project is set up, you will need to enter your AWS credentials. After this, you can configure replication settings like the source and target, as well as additional settings like server type, subnet, security group, EBS volume type, network configuration, etc. You can also encrypt the volumes, attach tags to the staging area resources, restrict the bandwidth, and update notification types. After you create a project, you can install the Cloud Endure agent on your source servers. You can grab the installation command from the Cloud Endure console from How to Add Machine tab and run this command on the source servers. The command downloads the Cloud Endure agent and starts the installation. In this demo, I have an SAP HANA Linux host with SAP HANA database installed and running on it. Here you can identify and select disks you want to replicate. You can also exclude certain disks from replication. Once the installer identifies the disks it needs to replicate, it starts downloading the Cloud Endure agent from the Cloud Endure service. These servers should be able to connect to Cloud Endure service on port 443. After the agent is installed, the source server is visible in the Cloud Endure console. Going back to the Machines tab, you can see here the machine has been registered into Cloud Endure console. It will do some preparations like creating security groups and rules. Once it is done, it will start the data replication process as well. At this point, you can update the server blueprint and modify any specific settings for replication. You can look at the security groups, designate an IP address, use an existing ENI, and which IAM role you will use when you launch this. You can also see the replication settings that you provided when you created the project, and you can change them here if you want. Under the Source tab, you will see all of the disks it is going to replicate. Cloud Endure will automatically start creating the staging area resources and then start the replication. You can see the progress of replication in the status bar. You will now have to wait until initial data sync is complete. If you want to perform some tasks when you launch a new EC2 instance, you can create post-launch scripts. These can be shell scripts able to complete an array of tasks like creating DNS entries, creating empty file systems that are not replicated, changing IP addresses, or any other custom tasks to be done after cutover. Now let's check back on our replication process. You can see here that the data replication is completed, and now you can perform a test cutover. This allows you to perform no impact mock cutovers while your source system is still in sync with the data in the VPC staging area. You can see the job in process. You can check for the updates in the logs. You can see that within 10 minutes, it has launched a new EC2 instance. Once you log in, you can see your system has been preserved and copied as is. After you have performed validation to your satisfaction, you wait for your migration cutover window. When it is time, you can cut over your SAP systems into AWS. Perform the validations on the new server. Perform post-processing and then release the new SAP HANA database to your users. Cloud Endure also provides APIs to automate the migration process. You can use cloud in your migration factory to migrate hundreds of servers at the same time. And that is how you migrate SAP applications and database to AWS with minimal downtime using AWS Cloud in your migration. Thank you for watching.